Welcome, ladies and gents, to our first TLP for Term 3, okay, which is really exciting. And of course, to celebrate Earth Week this week, we have got a number of events, and this is one of the highlights. Joined on stage with me today, I have Jo Leen, soon to be Dr. Jo Leen, hopefully, who is completing her PhD in Dusky Langurs, okay, and has been involved in a number of different TED Talks. So we are extremely lucky to have her with us today. So without further ado, I'm going to hand over to Jo Leen. Thank you, Jo Leen.
All right. A very good day to everyone. Can you hear me well? If yes, say Duskies, come. Thank you. All right. And do you know how Dusky Langurs say hi to each other? Do you know how they do that? Do they say hi? Do you know how they do it? This is how they do it. Eric, come here. They groom each other like this. All right. So I want all of you guys to groom yourself, to give yourself a huge pat on the shoulder. All right. For being here today, being such awesome audience. All right, let's get straight to it. So in this 20 minutes presentation, I'm going to make it fun. I'm going to make it short and sweet. Less talking from me, but I'm going to play you more videos so that you can immerse yourself and relax a little bit while looking at the footage of the Dusky Langurs. All right, so today I would like to tell you guys a story of Dusky Langurs. But first of all, do you know that Malaysia has 25 species of primates? To be exact, at least 25 species of primates. So, what are primates? Primates are basically humans, so we are primates, and also non-human primates such as monkeys, small apes, and big apes. Who can give me some example of apes? Any idea? Yes? Gorilla, amazing. What else? Orangutans, gibbons. Well, Dusky Langurs, they are one of the monkey species you can find in Malaysia, one of the at least 25 species of primates, yeah? So today, we're going to look at the Dusky Langur in a closer view. As you can see, all right, this is the adult individual with the black grayish hair. While the babies, the infants, they are very unique. They are orange in color. So many people have been wondering, why are they orange in color, yeah? Are they like the story of a Sun Wukong, the orange monkey? Actually, orange fur is one of the characteristics for this species, where the orange fur will start shed off at the age of 3 weeks old and slowly replace with dark grayish fur. And eventually, around 4 to 5 months years old, they will look like they are adult individuals, yeah? So, where can we find them? Can we only find them in Penang? No. Follow the red dot, yeah? If you can see the red dot, all right? So, you can find them not only in Peninsula Malaysia, part of Malaysia over here, but also certain parts of Thailand and Myanmar. They used to be near threatened species, yeah? Used to be near threatened before 2020, before the whole pandemic started. But then, the IUCN Red List updated their status into endangered species since June 2020. So, why are they endangered? Keep this question in your mind, because I want you to keep thinking of it. Why are this beautiful, adorable animal endangered? Why and how? Which we're going to talk more about it later. So, myself, Jo Leen, Eric, and Elvia, three of us with the adorable monkey t-shirt over here, we are from Langur Project Penang, which is a research and conservation group based in Penang, Malaysia. We conduct research projects. We go into the forest with binoculars, with GPSs, and we study the ecology, behavior, and road ecology of Dusky Langurs. What are these terms? I have no idea, you must be wondering. So basically, their life, their food, their friends, where do they go, where can we find them, how good are their homes? These are all the ecology and behavior surfaces that we need to explore in order to know how to protect these monkeys, all right? So these are the wonderful faces of the team members in our group, where we have the uncles, aunties, young individuals, youngest is like 16 years old, all of them sweated off in the field in order to study the dusky langurs, in order to protect them. So this is what we usually do. We would dress up in white uniform and we'll use our binoculars to stare into nowhere. You may not see anything from this picture, right? But if you use the binoculars, look into the leaves, the foliage, you'll see, fluffy white hair crowned. Look closer. You can see the creamy patch of the mouth of a dusky langur and the dark grey body fur as well. And of course, the name dusky leaf monkeys also means the colour of the fur, dusky dark grey body fur colour, as well as the round spectacle. Hence their other name, spectacle monkey. Also, they have opposable hand to grasp, just like humans. If you pay attention to our finger, our thumb, is totally rotatable, opposable. So this is one of the characteristics of primates, humans and non-human primates. We can grab things like this, and we can hold spoons and forks or even books. For dusky langurs, they can do that too. They are social primates. They live in groups just like us. If one of their family members get hurt, they would go to that member in order to do their best to protect them. So we are similar in many, many ways. But of course, humans, we are terrestrial, right? We live on the ground. Yes, we can climb tree, but dusky langurs and other monkeys and apes, they are better climber. They sleep on tree branches. They play on tree branches. They even say hi, like Eric and I groom each other just now on the tree branches itself. The species is folivorous. Their main diet is consumed of young leaves. 60% of their diet consists of leaves, yeah? And majority of their diet is choosing the young lack of chlorophyll leaves, which is full of fiber, as well as crude protein as well. So without leaves, without trees, they can't survive. But of course, out of the 100% of the diet, 25% consists of fruits. So when there's fruiting season of fig trees, or even some heritage trees around the urban area, like in Balai Pulau, the dusky langurs, squirrels, macaques, the urban animals will forage for fruits, and once they eat the food, they defecate, and they'll help plant trees around the green lungs around us, in the forest, or even in urban areas as well. Look at this. Two different monkeys coexist with each other in the forest. If there's one thing that I have to highlight after 6.5 years studying this species of monkey, is I learned how to coexist with the nature surrounding of us. This is the purpose of the Earth Day, right? Purpose of the Earth Week. It's not for us to be like, oh, we have to really protect the Earth, like being an Avenger, something like that. It's more about learn how to appreciate what we have around us and coexist with what we have, the minimalistic lifestyle we have, as well as appreciating the urban wildlife around us. Unfortunately, due to development, we have destroyed the homes of the nature, the wildlife. So the distance between human population area is closer to the forest, hence closer to animals. These are all due to habitat loss and habitat fragmentation. Basically, a forest being split into tiny fragments, which cause animals like monkeys to have difficulties and challenges to cross road, to find their mates, even to explore their home range. For dusky langurs, they're arboreal. They live in the trees. So it would be very hard for them to cross from one fragment to another, especially the fragments are being divided by huge highways or even roads. This draw closer the distance between humans and monkeys, where people empathy use it on the wrong way, and feeding monkey become a norm around tourism spots or even neighborhood area, such as in Penang, Botanical Gardens, Youth Park, people are feeding monkeys. But feeding monkeys draws the distance between humans and monkeys, hence disease transmission, zoonosis disease, and also cause aggression in the monkeys, hence more human-monkey conflict. So feeding monkey is a no-no thing to do. With habitat fragmentation and habitat loss, poachers and hunters don't have to go into the forest to camp for 3 nights to catch a monkey. They can just wait by the road. When they see a monkey, give them food, and they can catch their baby easily. So, illegal wildlife pet trade can be achieved through catching urban animals around our neighborhood. And illegal wildlife pet trade is still a very, very common thing to look at, especially on social media, where hunters are catching the baby monkeys like Dusky Langurs and sell it on social media like Facebook and Instagram. While all of these are illegal, but local enforcement is just not strong enough. So, for us, our team, we wanted to tackle these three main issues: roadkills, human feeding habit, as well as illegal wildlife pet trade. We ask ourselves, how can we coexist with monkeys? Hence, one of the ways that we came up with is on the Canopy Bridge project. We wanted to connect the fragments caused by fragmentation. So we built Malaysia's first road canopy bridge to help animals to cross road safely. When the animals don't have to run across the road, they can just transpass from one fragment to another place without any interaction with humans on the ground. As you can see over here, this video is captured by the camera trap that we install on the bridge itself, where the Dusky Langurs, they are using the bridge very frequently in order to cross from one side of the road to another side of the road without the need of being hit by cars or even interact with humans. Simple solution by communities can make a difference to the animals as well as driver's safety. And thanks to schools such as POVIS, we are able to engage with teachers and students to organize programs. So all these programs led us to communicate with students through your five senses: sense of smell, sense of touch, and bring you into the rainforest to develop the sense of appreciation towards nature. Now, ask yourself, can you help a monkey out? Can you? Yes or no? Yes? Yes, but how? There are many ways, but start with two more simplest ways, which is advocate for monkeys are not pets, as well as do not feed the monkeys. Through these two small actions, you can make a difference, as well as report your sightings of the Dusky Langurs as well as urban wildlife to us or even to your friends who are scientists studying animals, where all this information can help us to identify where to build the next bridge and where to organize educational campaign to stop people from interacting with the monkeys, all right? So small contributions such as no feeding monkeys, advocate for wild animals not being pets, as well as reporting all these urban sightings, are able to contribute to conservation in Malaysia. Remember, to help monkeys or help any wildlife in general, you don't really have to be a scientist. You can be a resident in your country, in Malaysia, or around your community in order to contribute, volunteer, and do your part as a citizen scientist. All right, so now I'm going to play you a video. Welcome to the story of Dusky Langurs. Dusky Langurs, also known as the Spatical Langurs or Dusky Leaf Monkeys. This species is well known for their white round spectacles and charismatic appearance.
Duskies means dark in color, and langur means leaf-eating monkey. They are arboreal, depending on trees to survive, where the species mainly feed on young leaves, fruits, and flowers. The dusky langurs have great balancing on trees, where they can sleep, sit, and grooming each other on tree branches. Dusky langurs can be found in Myanmar, Thailand, and Peninsular Malaysia, including small islands. There is a big boss, the alpha male in a group of dusky langurs, where he leads the family to forage and feed, at the same time protecting the family members. Sounds like our fathers, right? Besides staying in the forest, we can find the dusky langurs by the coastal area, in recreational parks where they are more used to human presence, and even urban areas where the species is struggling to survive in a human-impacted world. Do you know that the dusky langurs is an endangered species under the IUCN Red List? Wow, look at the babies of the dusky langurs. They are bright orange in colors, where the color serves as a reminder to the family members to pay attention to the baby, to ensure the safety and well-being of the young one. The baby has a strong bond with the mother. Here, the mommy dusky langur is grooming the orange baby. As the baby grows, the orange fur will slowly shed off and replace with growth of dark grayish fur by 5 months old. Overall, dusky langurs, they are very similar to us humans. We are all social animals. We are all primate species. Although dusky langurs are leaf-eating monkeys, they also feed a lot on fruits too. These are some examples of the fruits they feed on: gerring, fireweed, and ficus. After feeding and exercising, the dusky langurs will then go to the toilet in the forest, just like us, humans. The droppings of the dusky langurs contain tiny seeds that would grow into seedlings in the forest in terms of environmental condition. This is known as forest regeneration. Dusky langurs are the gardeners of the forest, where the species, alongside the birds, insects, and other mammals in the forest, working together to maintain the healthy ecosystem of the forest. Without the flora and fauna diversity in the forest, our ecosystem may collapse. Alright, who are the friends of the dusky langurs? First, the long-tailed macaques. You may see them in parks and urban areas. However, do you know that the natural habitat of the macaques is in the forest too? Dusky langurs and long-tailed macaques both share the same habitat, where the young ones of both species would play together. And if you are lucky, you may have the chance to witness interspecies grooming between both species. Here, both adult dusky langur and long-tailed macaque are grooming each other peacefully. This is known as coexistence. Wow, what is this? A Sunda colugo. Sunda colugo is a mysterious species where not many people have seen them before. They are so well camouflaged that dusky langurs sometimes miss them too. Next, the fluffy black giant squirrel. The black giant squirrel is one of the largest squirrel species in Southeast Asia. This species is near threatened and can be found foraging and feeding on trees with the dusky langurs. Here is a precious site where a juvenile dusky langur tried to play with the black giant squirrel. However, the squirrel doesn't seem to bother. Okay everyone, let's listen to the call. This is a racket-tailed drongo, a beautiful bird with loud calls and racket-looking tail. This species can be found flying around mammals to obtain food such as insects. Okay, are you ready for another friend of dusky langurs? Snakes! Snakes can be intimidating to many people, including the dusky langurs as well. Hence, when dusky langurs spotted any snakes, they would defend the family members by trying to scare the snakes away, or retreat to safe areas in the forest. Here, you can hear the alpha dusky langurs making the alarm call, warning his family about the existence of a reticulated python. The greatest threat towards the dusky langur is habitat loss and fragmentation. Living in this human-impacted world, the dusky langurs are struggling to survive. And most time, they move along cable wires to cross the road, where there's a risk of electrocution and falling to the road. Sometimes, when there's no connectivity at all, the dusky langurs would run across the road to the other side of the habitat to look for food or regroup with their family members. Worse, road accidents happen, where unfortunate dusky langurs lost their life. This is not a dog. It is a pet monkey. There's a demand for exotic pet, where poachers are hunting for wild animals, including the dusky langurs, to sell as pets, illegally on the social media market. Wild animals, including primates, belong in the wild. It is so important for human beings to understand the fact that primates are not pets. We can do our part to raise awareness to stop the demand for illegal wildlife pet trade, hence stopping the trade of wild animals. Do you think feeding monkeys is a correct thing to do? Many people feeding wild animals due to sympathy and unethical tourism purpose. Feeding wild monkeys can cause overcrowding behavior of the monkeys, aggression among the monkeys to humans, increasing the negative human-monkey interface incidents, and enhance disease transmission. Feeding monkey also causes pollution, where the food packaging and rubbish can be found near the forest edges and neighborhood areas. The lack of monkey-proof bins in many parks encourage the monkeys to look for food in the rubbish bin, therefore polluting the environment. Monkeys' food are the plants and small animals in the forest, not human food. Human food is high in sugar and preservative, can cause health problems to the monkey, such as heart disease and obesity. We are the Langur Project Penang, LPP, a citizen science-based research and outreach project in Malaysia that focuses on the dusky langur's conservation efforts. The members of the LPP conduct fieldwork in the forest, surveying the distribution of the dusky langurs, studying the ecology and behavior of the species in Penang. We also look at the activities, food plants, home range, and habitat qualities of the dusky langurs. To assist dusky langurs and other arboreal animals to cross roads safely, LPP has installed the first urban canopy bridge in Malaysia. The objective of the bridge is to mitigate the impact of habitat fragmentation, providing a safe corridor for wild animals to move within fragmented habitat. We, Langur Project Penang, believe in the power of environmental education. We conduct regular rainforest walks for local communities to experience the beauty of the forest through their five different senses. Children have the chance to learn about the flora and fauna of the forest through the eyes of the dusky langurs, while the adults and students gain the opportunities to get involved in wildlife conservation through volunteering and learning how to promote coexistence among humans and wildlife residents.
Thank you so much for watching the story of dusky langurs. If you guys would like to do your part in conserving the dusky langurs, here are the few steps for you to help this species of primate. First, educate. Talk to your friends and family regarding the uniqueness and interesting fact about dusky langurs. Second, get involved by volunteering in our fieldwork program, or even engage in environmental education of dusky langurs, or even you can join us on board by creating social media content they're able to spread to wider range of audience. But of course, if you can't get involved in the field or even in our center itself, you can always donate. Donate to our conservation effort so that you can help do your part in our research, conservation and education.
Of course, our Malaysian and fellow international friend, you can also help nature and wildlife by practicing leave no trace. So basically, do not litter, handle your own trash when you go hiking or even adventuring in the nature trail. Remember to leave nothing but footprints. Especially right now, during the COVID-19 pandemic, there are many people leaving the disposable face masks everywhere, including along the forest trail as well. And this kind of increased the risk of disease transmission between wild animals, especially monkeys, and humans, ourselves. So everyone, do our part by educate, get involved, donate, and as well as practicing leave no trace. Thank you so much.
So hopefully you learn at least something about Dusky Langurs and the importance of being a wildlife advocate. So I shall pass the mic to them.
Thank you very much, Jo Leen. Hopefully you've all learned something from this experience today. Tomorrow we will have the stall still open and the booth for you to be able to look at in the canteen. All the money that we've ultimately raised today goes towards the Langur Project and also to the Bahenthian Island Turtle Project as well. Can I have a round of applause for our guest speaker, Jo Leen? Thank you. So on that note, ladies and gents, thank you very much for joining us for this term's first TLT. And I look forward to seeing you with more Earth Action events taking place tomorrow with our Interhouse Scavenger Hunt. Thank you very much, Powis. You are dismissed. Thank you.